welcome you to Arbor Christian Fellowship. And so good that you're here and see our Kids Alive presentation. Let me open up with a word of prayer. Father, we come before you this morning on this day. We thank you for your presence with us. And we thank you for these children. We thank you for the families, the moms and dads and relatives and the leaders. And we just pray that you would be glorified. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Just one announcement. And that is, we're having Vacation Bible School this summer, July 8 through 12, from 8:30 a.m. 12. There's a sheet in your program to take. So put a magnet on your refrigerator or in your computer or in your iPad calendar and thing, and we're going to have a great Vacation Bible School. Now, when they perform and sing and everything, if they're, clap. Clap and then be enthused and encourage them. What a wonderful thing. So I present to you right now, Arbor Kids Alive.
Hey! from the Pearly Gate Plaza, it's your hosts, Cameron Flowers and Summer Showers.
Good morning to all the heavenly hosts. It's another beautiful day here at the Pearly Gates. We are so glad you joined us for Faith News today.
As you know, we shine a big golden spotlight on God's people.
Those who trust Him and His promises.
It's always an honor to sit here next to my co-hosts, Summer Showers and Autumn Reeves. And may I just say, Summer, you have a brilliant new Goldspot hairdo today.
Thank you, Cameron. I have to admit, I peeked at the lineup we have for today, and it is halo-tastic.
Yeah, it's real cloud-buster.
With that, let's go to our roving angel reporters on the ground.
Yes, the gold stick.
So, can you tell us a little about what is going on with your husband, Noah?
If you're going to make fun of him too, I'm not going to...
Oh no, we're very interested in the construction project going on here.
Oh, in that case, here's the boat. Noah told me that God said he should build a very big boat called...
An ark.
You've heard of it? And of course, I told him it's going to be expensive.
I imagine so.
You have no idea. So, not the boat. I think, what do I care? He has a hobby. Then he wants to put animals in it. But get this, not just the animals he owns. He wants to put two of every animal on the boat.
That's a lot of animals.
Clean up on aisle 5.
Exactly. So that's what I've been doing for the past year.
Starting our own zoo.
But don't know you plan it, mind you. All of God's creatures are valuable. I don't want
to
be...
Mrs. Noah, I don't mean to interrupt, but do you think we could get your husband to come over?
Sure. I gotta go feed the camels and giraffes anyway. Hey, Noah!
Yes, did you call me?
Call me by your friends. They're not making fun of us. They're actually interested in what God had to say.
Definitely.
Well, we know...
Talking to the golden stick, honey.
I've learned when God says something, I should obey. He's never given me a reason to doubt Him. And if God says it's gonna rain, it's gonna...
It's gonna rain.
It sure is. You know, having faith means believing what God says is real, even though you can't see it. Let's go back to our roving angel reporters on the ground in Susa.
Thank you.
Christians. Everyone had heard of him, and he was scary.
Super scary. I remember that. I think this is a perfect moment for what Cameron, Summer, and I like to call fantastic faithing.
Thank you.
we go to our correspondence. Fly Wingspan and Fly Halo Span. Correspondence, can you hear me?
Yes, Cameron.
Yes, Summer.
We hear flying over Bethlehem, where there is a camel broken down by the side of the road. It's going to take a while to clear those two speed humps. And over at Samson's village, two enormous pillars have fallen, blocking all access to the main road.
If you travel back a few centuries, looks like the roads around the Red Sea just emptied. So smooth traveling there.
And that's traffic with Halo Span
and Wingspan.
Back to the newsroom.
Thanks for that eye in the sky report, Halo Span and Wingspan. Now we take you back where... Am I hearing this right?
Yes, they're walking. I repeat, they're not flying, but walking with the group around the city of Jericho. crumble.
You know, it sometimes looks like foolishness, but it's what pleases God.
So true, Cameron and Autumn. Let's go to the ground, Chara and Celeste. What's happening down there?
Oh.
the non-denominational Napfest on the Golden Clouds.
Of course, a real FNN favorite. Let's go to Jared and Jewish.
That's a pretty big promise.
Yep, but God said it, and I believe him.
Trust and believe. Will you hear?
delivered Jericho into their hands.
Queen Esther risked her life to save her people.
Faith of any size comes through hearing of promises of God,
believing them and acting on them.
You know, to have this faith, we need to know what God has promised.
That's why it's so important to read and know the Word of God.
All His promises are yes in Christ Jesus.
Right, let's give it up one more time for all the kids. What a great job, what a great job. Just a couple of things before we're finished. Arbor members, those of you that are prepared to give your tithes and offering, there'll be offering plates with our men in the back on your way out. Thank you so much, moms and dads, grandmas, grandpas, aunts and uncles, in-laws, outlaws, anybody, everybody who are coming to support your kids. And we value kids at Arbor. We have Awana Children's Church and, of course, Kids Alive. It's been going on over 30 years. And Hilda leading, Marilyn helping, and others. And an amazing thing is some of these children's parents were in Kids Alive. So just an amazing, amazing thing. Want to do some recognition and have some recognition of our leaders and things. So, Ava, you come, and we're going to pass out some things, and then I'll have Hilda come, and she'll say a few words, and I'll come back and close and dismiss us in prayer.
Did they do wonderful? I know, watching them tonight, or today, reminded me of two things that your kids will be blessed with through Kids Alive. One of them is, it's one of the few ministries you might have served where the kids actually get to interact and work with other kids, different ages. The older ones get to sing and dance or work with kids younger than them. The older ones get to interact with older ones. For each song, you usually have a different partner. And then secondly, God uses the songs and the storylines that they've learned and heard and you've heard in the car that God will use to minister to them. I know even last night, Miss Hilda shared what her granddaughter was feeling well, and she slept herself. She put herself to sleep singing one of the songs. So I know I've done that to my daughter where I said, remember that song, and then they'll remember and the Lord will use it to them. So please invite kids to join us again in September. And we just wanted to acknowledge those who've made this possible. So Ms. Chelsea. Ms. Brenda.
Chris is a genius behind Kids Alive and the drill instructor and everything else involved. So Hilda.
That's only because I was married to a Marine, so. But anyway, I just want to thank all the families, because there's a lot of families represented here. And all these kids, we work them very, very hard, but we want them to learn that when they work for God, you do your best. And you always give your best. And when you give your best, God blesses. So I just want you to know that I pray that God blesses each one of you families who have children up here on the stage and that have had children up here on the stage. In fact, we have alumni out in the audience. If you're an alumni, Kids Alive, former Kids Alive kids, will you stand? There's a few. So we thank you. We thank our staff in the back, Daniel and Isabel. And as you know, this is not a one-person production. It takes an awful lot of people. We are the body of Christ. Each person has their specialty, and we all come together to put on something like this. And I just thank God that he's able to use us and to use kids to convey his message through song and dance. So we're excited. If you would like to participate in this program in the future, just come talk to me or to Chelsea or to Miss Brenda. Miss Brenda, you like the staging? Miss Brenda, we were here past midnight on Friday night, trying to get the stage in order. And parents, because it took us to do that, and we have, let me recognize Maria. Where are you, Maria? Maria, where are you? Maria. Greenhard. And Shelly. So just to let you know, there is longevity in this program. Kids, stand up. I want you to give them another applause. For them. We're going to go ahead and allow you to take pictures of them at the end, but I'm going to let the pastor dismiss us in prayer. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much. A lot of moving parts. Oh man, God bless you. If you have any questions about your heart, your soul, your eternal destiny, or accepting Jesus as your Savior, I'll be available in the foyer, parking lot, hallway. Come and talk to me. I'd love to talk to you. Father, we thank you for Kids Alive. We thank you for this time. We thank you for recapping and acting out the drama and the truths of the Bible. We thank you for these children. We just pray your protection, your guidance, your blessing upon them. I thank you for the families that they come from. And Lord, help us as a church family to help raise their kids in this world, to give them values and strengths, to opportunities for service. And we just want to give you glory and praise. We pray in Jesus' name, amen.
Good, how are you? That was cute. I thought it was, hi, how are you? Say hi to your hubby. Alright. Yeah. Yeah, take care, brother.
Today, and this was a special presentation, and we'll look forward to seeing you next week. Tell somebody that Jesus loves you, and we'll see you next Sunday.
Yeah, we'll get on the church website.